Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from, as well as the other Patreon-exclusive content, head over to patreon.com/raprankings. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast. Track 1, Phone Numbers, featuring Trey the Truth and Big Sean, produced by Drummer Boy. I called the number. The phone was turned off. Flat 6.
7 minus. Sting me, baby.
Moulz got through.
I got through, but just barely. This is, you know, obviously novelty sampling at its finest. We got Queen, We Are the Champions, which is not the first time it's been sampled, by the way. We'll
talk about that in a second. Or the last, probably.
Yeah, so you've got this beat that, you know, is pitched up, We Are the Champions sample. And other than that, it is kind of like a, you know, trap percussion underneath still. It's in line with the stuff we get in terms of the programming, but we don't really get like sample based songs like this for the rest of the tape. You know, so that's how this thing is, to me, distinguishing itself from other records on this tape. Because a problem with this project for me, even within the 9 tracks, is that too much sounds alike. So this automatically stands out. And yeah, it's kind of a gimmicky sample. Definitely not digging in the crates for something like this. But I like the flip.
Well, you know, I actually like the flip too. And I'm glad you pointed out it's like one of the only sample-based things on here. It's a very blog era kind of flip too, in like the chops, and I like it. It's a good thing, and you know, we don't often say positive things about the blog era on this show, but I like this flip. It's a good flip. With a better rapper, I would have been probably trying to tell kids about this shit like the rest of these blog era fucking, you know, sympathizers. Like, oh, you wasn't there. Y'all wasn't outside for that phone numbers. I can't go that far, but like, I like this flip. It feels like a song that would have been made if Dipset debuted in like the late 2000s.
Well, like, funny enough, I mean, I have something here in the archival that came before this did, right? And Cameron's on it. So exactly. We'll get to that in just a sec. But I feel like, you know, other than Trey the Truth, who's like sandwiched in between Wiz and Big Sean on here, I have issues with the verses. Wiz is like effervescent. Like, he could just might as well not even be there. It's just in one ear, out the other. I don't latch on to a single thing that he says. It's totally hollow. There's not one moment where I'm like, oh, that's a bar. Big Sean is memorable but annoying. Talking about, oh my gosher. You know, it's like annoying rap that made me, especially at this point in time, like really hate any song that featured Big Sean. So back in the day, this was probably not a takeaway for me. I don't mind Sean on the chorus here, though. I thought with him, just with that melodic, you know, styling on the chorus, with Wiz in between rapping, there was good juxtaposition between the melody and the rapping. It sounded like they were in the room together. I don't know if they were. Not really any issue with the chorus here or with Trey the Truth. I like the flip. I have different issues with the bookending verses on here.
Funny, because to me, now look, this is from somebody who nowhere near a big fan of Big Sean. But I like more than 10 Big Sean songs, which, you know, our metric is if you like more than 10 songs, you consider yourself a fan. I'm a fan of Big Sean. You know, at this time, I never took him seriously. But with distance, like, you know, the most zaniest. He's the most zaniest. And a lot of these rappers from Detroit are zany. Him, Eminem, Sada Baby. This might just be Detroit zaniness. At the time, I'm like,
but it's like SPR zaniness, you know?
Yeah, small penis rap. We'll get up. RapRankings.com glossary, folks. Small penis rap zaniness, sure. But like now, it's almost like I appreciate it more because ain't enough zany, it feels like, these days. And like, this is like, I'm not saying it's a good verse or good rapping, but I'm here for this, like, just whacked out cheesiness. Like, this beat almost feels like it was made for him on like his one of his tapes.
Like a finally famous type of beat, basically.
Right. You know, real shit boys, niggas, imposters, they deserve an Oscar, Kevin Costner. Oh my gosher. Like, oh my gosher. Like, I went up for it. Like, yeah, it's not good rapping. Got your bitch's panties, Niagara falling. Like, yeah, that's not great. My dick hard, your bitch is easy. But like, I don't know. Like, it's, I do know, actually. I don't know. It's bad in a good way.
Like, you it's know, very Wiz, low stakes. That Wiz verse is kind of meat and potatoes. And Big Sean fault. Is like meat and potatoes, but he took, remember the ketchup that was different colors? Like, he's just right. squirting that the all Heinz, over the meat and potatoes.
Yeah, the purple ketchup. Right. It's that, and it's like.
So it is, I find it irritating, but it's memorably irritating as opposed to Wiz, who's just like such an afterthought on his own song. It's really a shame. Like, he's even the lesser part of the chorus. The melodic Big Sean stuff works better than the rapping. Like, the rapping didn't need to be there. Without the Big Sean, you know, this song would feel kind of dead.
Yeah.
You know? So I just appreciate, you know, what Trey the Truth brought to this. His voice sounded great on the beat. And we'll play a little bit of this in a sec, but why don't we play the sample if for some reason people haven't heard it. If this is on YouTube and this particular sample ends up getting blocked, them's the breaks, okay? It's Queen. We are the champions.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shots and kicks in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go on.
No goddamn dissect podcast. We the ghosts. We the ones, nigga. We the ones. Okay, rap rankings. All right, that's our theme. We are the champions. All right.
That's how Dame Dash was feeling when he put out Champions featuring Kanye West, Beanie Siegel, Cameron, and Young Chris.
Oh, that's how he felt, huh?
That's how he was feeling.
Well, let's see how he was feeling. We got the audio right here.
No shit. No shit. No. Score tip, score tip.
What's up, y'all? Yo, this is Dame Dash, the CEO. Here to welcome y'all to the Dream Team. What y'all niggas thought I was gonna rap? Never. I'm just a little mad at niggas coming at my neck like my teammate the best in the world. You know what I'm saying? Like, we ain't got beef. Cam, Jay, Bleak, Freeway.
Jay's gonna leave in a year, dude. Door. Gonna leave all you motherfuckers, all right? And he's gonna take this guy who's gonna rap first with him, okay? He shouldn't have left his ass to rot too.
The people's choice, DJ Envy.
God damn, Kanye! I bet niggas didn't know you could rap, huh?
Rumble past
that's my motherfucking producer. That's the producer on the rock. He rap better.
Well, Dame, if these niggas thought about they self for a change.
Shut the fuck up, Nazi. Stupid ass booty out in fucking Europe. Getting top. Rosy cheek, weirdo ass nigga. Let me not.
Stinky
me not
ass man, okay? But yeah, Cameron's on there.
Right.
If you wanted to hear what he sounds like on that beat, go look up the song. We're not here to give you the full song.
All right.
You know, you gotta do research, you know, when the show's over, I hope you have a whole notepad document of all the songs you got to go look up. Okay. That's how you rap. Over.
Oh, yeah. Kick it.
Okay. You got to go kick it on fucking YouTube and Wikipedia and do that, like, you know.
I don't know about y'all, but, like, you know, when I see movies, one of the great joys of watching a movie or a TV show is, you know, you got to go on the internet after and read.
Yeah, you got to do the, you know, bonus.
Right.
Extracurricular legwork to really make it worth your while.
That's right.
But, yeah, it's time for phone numbers, Mel. Wiz Khalifa, Trey the Truth, and Big Sean, which kicks off this Crabbin' Fever mixtape that we're reviewing right now.
Crabbin' Fever. Yep, here we go.
Listen to this track, bitch.
Yeah. Usually I'd be smoking weed on the intro, but I'm drinking water. This Cabin Fever. Sick. And I'm not gonna tell you again. Stay the hell away from my woman. Taylor gang niggas think you can do whatever you want. I cop me one for my old girl. You think she my newest bitch, she my old girl. Khalifa, a younger nigga who handle his. Hoes get in my car, ask what the channel is. Bullshit, look that up, my nigga. I handle biz. On fire like a candle is. Niggas be dressing off the mannequin. And I get fresh like where them cameras is. Better yet, sandwiches. Bad bitch, Spanish friends. Could have been the president. Rather be the man instead, yeah. Now when I get paid, my checks be looking like phone numbers. Now when I get paid, my checks be looking like phone numbers. I'm talking millions, nigga. I'm talking millions. I'm talking millions, nigga. I'm talking millions. Time is money, so I went and bought a
I played it, you know, a little deeper into the song so they could hear certain things. Wiz, you asked me to when you said boss shit. Look that up, my nigga. Okay, so I did. The first result, Urban Dictionary, boss shit. When you take a shit on the desk, chair, drawer, or garbage can of your boss when he slash she pisses you off. Okay. Thanks, Wiz. You know, that intro, you were chuckling. I was chuckling all week because it's such a,
okay.
It's like, I usually be smoking weed, but I'm drinking water. And then all of a sudden it's like, I'm not going to tell you again, stay the hell away from my woman. It's like, who is he talking to? You know, but it's interesting. It's more interesting than his verse, for the record. Sure.
The way he raps, I think the best rappers put me in such a state of disbelief that it's like they're riding a unicycle, right?
Right, yeah.
Good rappers, though, are like riding a bicycle. And then, like, Wiz Khalifa is like riding the bike with the training wheels on the back. Like, that's how he raps.
Right.
He's not even at the regular bicycle level of rapping.
Yeah, I mean, my note was bad rapping. Like, it wasn't good rapping. I mean, on fire like a candle is. Okay. All right, if that's the best you want to put forth, huh? Whatever. I hope y'all heard, too. It's a good beat. I like the beat, but I think the mix is bad, especially when that bass gets overwhelming.
A little too light in the ass on the sample side. And then, yeah, the bass is sometimes, like, boom, clipped boom, up boom, a little too loud.
Yeah.
Last night, I DM'd you, Mel.
You did?
Unprompted. And just said, yeah. Eminem said, switchblade with a little switch to switch blades and switch from a 6 to a 16-inch blade on Rap Game off the 8 Mile soundtrack. Ran the verse back 5 times and I've heard it a million times. Like, Eminem, Wiz will never have a moment like that for me.
Right. I will point out lines throughout the night that, like, actually, you know, made me feel something. You know, positive emotions, but he's not the guy for that for me. You know, yeah. In the chorus, y'all heard, and you pointed out earlier, I like the Big Sean and Trey the Truth kind of like doing backup phrase repeating. Mm-hmm. It's a nice effect. I'm talking millions. Like, it is, yeah. That was good. But you know, Trade the Truth, my main man, my close personal friend, who all you all know by now, almost opened up for back in the day. I don't think he really said anything. He sounds like his voice.
It's
is
his
good,
voice, but, man. He's got that right. smoky, husky sounding voice, and he's just got that presence, you know?
Right. Better Real than Wiz. I'll give him that.
You know?
Yeah, player. That's why I couldn't open up for him, because as we know, I'm not a player. but
this, yeah. I guess, made an impact because Fab rapped on it on the Soul tape, apparently.
Oh, so fabulous.
We have the phone numbers freestyle as well.
All right. Well, let's dial that number. Oh, it's an even worse mix.
What the hell? This is the Soul tape you guys like so much.
Y'all niggas better stop playing with me. Y'all know y'all ain't about that life. Soul tape. Nice. I'm calling them out. I got their phone number. I'm calling them out. I got their phone number. When that money calling, everything go on hold. When that money calling, everything go on hold. I'm having doubts with the really believe. Starting with these Stefan Urkels who really be Steve. Photoshop don't make it better, it really deceives. Long hair, don't care, but it really be weed. Let's get back to this real shit, that life I'm about. Anytime that I'm out, I keep balling like it's no timeouts. On the cush, I'm stoned out.
Oh, brother. Okay.
Jesse, please stop comparing Lloyd Banks to Fabulous.
Yeah, man, don't do that.
And
don't
do for that. All the Soul tape dick riders out there, we're coming for this mixtape one of these days, okay? Because I know this tape's not as good as you motherfuckers say it is.
Where's I gotta, yeah, because you're right. If that's what that shit sounds like, Fabulous, I got a message for you.
I'm that nigga that you should really be afraid of. I dig graves for niggas like you. We gonna get more acquainted at a time when you least expect it.
Okay, but yeah, what else we got?
One more for Sean, Manny Pacquiao. I don't know if this just samples the Queen song or if it also incorporates phone numbers, but it's the last piece of archival for this particular record tonight.
All right, for Sean. Was he a double XL freshman?
Yeah, one of those years he was.
Okay, that's what I thought. All right, here we go. Manny Pacquiao.
Champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting.
I'm about to punch one of these niggas in their face, man. Fucking Iron Mike, nigga. Iron Sean, nigga. Iron Curves, nigga. Cement shoes, nigga. May you sleep with the piranhas. Your fucking favorite rapper's favorite rapper, nigga. I feel like the Lakers, man. Niggas don't want to give me my respect, huh? Y'all niggas kiss DJ the ring. Fuck the punk. Witness is Sean, invented in a minute or more. Like a chemist, guess who kicked in the door with a fifth of gin, beam in his veins. G on his chain, me in the game. Pitching the game like Chris Carpenter, rope with a thick squadron. What I ought to give you artists is a trip to a mausoleum. Stop stopping, you gotta see him. Next time, probably riding something European. What the fuck's my passport? I need to get out of here. High enough to kick the stratosphere. Roll the carpet out. Your majesty's here, I'm velour, y'all cashmere. The champ's back and you can't cheer. Besides Christ ain't a spirit that this man fears. If I ain't the best, I'm damn near. Tell me how you plan to hang with a chandelier. Your whole camp queer, gang of Pam Greers. To all hustlers, I'm front of work. Never wanted to wear cleats, just wanted to run the turf. Beat twice, I be burying niggas. He's nice, but don't compare him to Jigga.
You know, I would hit him with that Triple H hip hop homophobia drop for saying your whole camp queers, but maybe he was just doing it in the theme of the song. You know, Manny Pacquiao is a homophobe. So, I don't know. Maybe he was just, you know, it was the theme.
Triple H on a Freddie Mercury sample is crazy.
Oh, you right. All right, I gotta hit it.
Time to play the game!
Come on, Fashawn. Come on, Pacquiao. Anyway,
Sean, that was for show, Triple H. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. But
Man, we got a whole rest of this tape to review, though. You got anything else to do phone numbers-wise, or are we going to pack it up and move on to the title track here?
Actually, hold on. Hold on. You know what? I do have something to do phone numbers-wise. Okay. You know, folks, as we record this, it's that Chrismo. Yeah. I got a call from my brother. But, you know, I'm recording this podcast, so I'll just let it ring. And then he texted me, Merry Christmas, dog. So, you know what? I'm going to call him live and see if he answers. And you know, because that's what you should do with family, right?
Imagine he pulls a rated R and he's like, who is this?
Who are you? Let me see. Hey, I was sending you a text to let you know I was recording right now. I think it just went through, but yeah, I just wanted to hit you. Yeah, hey, that's love, dog. Merry Christmas. You live right now on the mic.
Wow, listen to the pop. They're freaking out. A bunch of Rab fans, it sounds like.
What'd you say? No, I said you're live on the podcast right now. I was calling you live because you know, yeah.
Nah, gang, I was in the trenches just a second ago. Trenches.
Hey, I feel you. I'm in the trenches too. But I'm doing this Wiz Khalifa
ain't
review.
No trenches. These ain't trenches.
He ain't good.
We're I feel in the like cabin. In the
trenches. But
nah, we really thugging out the solo Christmases. This is so crazy.
Yeah, I'm in the house alone. It's kind of fucked up. But
nah, man, I'm with another family alone. So that's even harder.
Oh, that's hard. Yeah, when you alone around people, yeah, that's a different feeling. Yeah. Hey, you know.
You heard how crazy it was.
Yeah.
I was not a part of none of that. I didn't put in on any of that noise.
You didn't. Yeah. Well, hey man, I'm gonna hit you later. I gotta keep talking about this dumbass Wiz Khalifa mixtape, but I'll holler at you.
Hey man, fuck Alder Dice.
Yeah, fuck Alder Dice, exactly. All right, love dog.
All right, love, man.
Yeah. How's my brother, y'all? That was who they know him on the show as not him. The famous phrase he had on the show, he's going to cousin Jacob's house to make bangers. Remember that, yeah. Y'all?
That's the man who makes bangers.
Yeah, it's the man who makes bangers. Yeah. It's Jesse popped. I know he did. It's folks, it's
Jesse rad doesn't listen rad. To these.
Oh, right, he don't listen to Patreon. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway,
He missing out.
But all right, folks. You want to move on? Are we done?
Yeah,
we're done
with the phone number. Yeah, we got plenty more songs to go. Oh wait, no, we don't.
Wiz, you're getting fucked, pal. All right.
Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from, as well as the other Patreon exclusive content, head over to patreon.com/raprankings. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast.